This week at Interior. For the past 2 weeks, Paris has been the center of the climate change universe as hundreds of world leaders descended on the City of Light to attend the 21st Conference of Parties, commonly known as COP21, or the Paris Climate Talks, discussions about climate change impacts and to map out a strategy to lower carbon emissions worldwide. Secretary Jewell joined President Obama and other U.S. officials to discuss the effects of climate change here at home and released a report on resilience efforts already underway. She kicked off the week by leading a panel discussion on what the United States is doing to help prepare communities and the ecosystems they depend on, from Alaska to the Pacific Islands like the Marshall Islands, prepare for the effects of climate change, from melting permafrost to rising tides, longer, drier, hotter wildfire seasons, and invasive species, among other concerns. Secretary Jewell also joined representatives from retail giant Marks & Spencer and global personal care company Unilever to announce a partnership to stop deforestation by improving their supply chain sourcing. Secretary Jewell also held bilateral meetings with representatives from Gabon, Kenya, and Namibia to further partnerships in the fight against wildlife trafficking. In Paris, Secretary Jewell released a report on actions already underway to combat climate change in our national park system, laying out a framework for discussions with the UNESCO World Heritage Committee, where delegates discuss challenges in protecting World Heritage sites in the face of climate change. The report explores adaptation and resilience strategies in place at parks like Everglades National Park in Florida and the Gateway National Recreation Area in New York. Find out more at doi.gov. Secretary Jewell rounded out her time in Paris by meeting with the French Minister of Justice to discuss how the U.S. and France can address the issue of Native American tribal sacred objects that are often sold at French auction houses. The Secretary is seeking cooperation with France to repatriate these objects to Indian tribes in the United States. As the Paris talks draw to a close, you can learn about the real-life effects of climate change on a small Inupiaq community of 650 people through the eyes of 18-year-old Esau Sanook, an Arctic Youth Ambassador who attended the Paris talks. Read his blog at doi.gov. That's This Week at Interior.